Good evening, friends, and welcome. Welcome to our pajama party slash virtual Christmas pageant. It's just us and the wonderful tech team, and Pastor Michelle is here to watch the show as well. It is a blessing to be with you. I don't know if you are comfy in your pajamas. It's not a requirement. You could also be in your Christmas best. I know Sarah, who is here with me, is rocking her Christmas leggings. This is just a way to be comfortable and be connected to the story. Because I don't know about you guys, but this has been a Christmas like no other. It has been stressful and filled with storms. And today, white Christmas means foggy Christmas. And so just take a moment and breathe. It is Christmas Eve. It is a night of the most anticipation of the whole Advent season. As we wait for Christmas tomorrow, it is a day when we have almost arrived. And so breathe in a moment of peace. And breathe out a little bit of that anxiety. One more time. And so we decided to do a virtual pageant this year. You'll notice Sarah and I both have our phones in our hand. So if you are connected to the live stream chat, we will be watching while we're watching the videos. You can chat with us. You can chat with each other. Talk about what your favorite parts are or the funny parts. There's a lot of humor going on in this. There are many different Marys. There are different Josephs. It is a home video extravaganza. It is COVID-style pageantry at its best.
It's perfect.
It reminds us what the beauty that can come from a COVID Christmas. And so, friends, I invite you to settle in as we begin our story as Sarah tells it to some of her littles.
Happily ever after. The end. That was a good one. Good night, girls. Sleep tight.
Wait a minute, Aunt Sarah. Don't leave yet. Can you stay a while longer?
Yeah.
What's going on, girls? You need to get some sleep.
I'm scared. That's what made me nervous. And now I'm thinking of about all the things I'm afraid of.
Like what?
Well, let's see. There's airplanes, bees, coronavirus, dogs, electric shock, fire, ghosts, snowstorms, thunderstorms, judgment, knife, slice, mice, nighttime, bears, poison, questions, roller coasters, spiders, teething, under my bed, violence, worms, X-rays, yellow fever, and Zoom!
Did you just list your fears in alphabetical order? Whoa. I can relate. I feel afraid sometimes.
So how do I feel better right now? I can't sleep when I'm scared.
Well, these stories help. Right? Mm-hmm. When I'm afraid or I'm worrying, I remember that I am a part of a story that is way bigger than myself. And God's story is full of people who are sometimes afraid. You know, I think I have time to tell you one more story tonight. Want to hear another story?
Yeah.
This part of God's story is during a time when many people were afraid of many things, just like us in 2020. It all begins in Nazareth, a town in Galilee, with a woman named Mary.
Oh, hi. Welcome. Welcome to my home. Do you want to talk to me? We haven't met before, have we? Do you want to hear what I have to say?
I do! Pardon me. Let me start over. Greetings, favored one. God is with you.
What kind of greeting is that?
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you are going to have a baby boy. You will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and his kingdom will have no end.
Well, how can this be? How is this going to happen?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. Also, your relative Elizabeth is going to have a baby, even though people thought it would be impossible.
Was all of that a question? Well, are you asking me if I want to do this?
Good question. Yes.
Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to his message. I need to see Elizabeth.
Save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect love? That sleeping child you're holding is the great
so blessed. The moment your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy.
Oh, that's wonderful. I believe you. I'm not going to touch it, but I believe you.
Very good.
And I am bursting with good news. I mean, I'm nervous, but it's good news too. Because God took one good look at me. And look what happened. I am the most blessed woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. I am talking about the God who knocked the powerful off their thrones and lifted up the lowly. So, can I stay with you for a few months?
Of course you can.
Oh, thank God.
Mary is pregnant. How is that possible? We aren't married yet, and the law says that's not good. Not good at all. She claims that this child, the child she's carrying, is actually God's child. My only option is to marry her and then divorce her quietly. That'll save my reputation, at least. Oh, but she'll be disgraced. I don't know what to do, and I'm afraid. Oh, Mary.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to get married. God's Holy Spirit has made Mary pregnant. She will have a son, and you will name him Jesus, God saves, because he will save his people from their sins.
Huh? I'm going to marry Mary? I'm going to marry Mary! And we're going to have a baby and name him Jesus. I'm going to be a dad. I need to pack.
Joseph was his earthly father. The wise men came from far. They were guided by a shining star.
Did you see Jesus where he lay?
Seems we might have missed a scene there. Can we rewind? Or is that for the next?
It's just a baby! This story is so weird.
Yeah. I don't know the answer to most of those questions. This is a bigger than life kind of story, and there are a lot of unexplainable and miraculous parts.
That sounds like what Pastor Michelle says when I ask hard questions.
Good. I'm glad I sound like Pastor Michelle, because we just don't have all the answers. Now, I do know the answer to one of those questions. Why is Jesus packing? To understand that, we need to meet the Emperor.
Welcome back, friends. We got to meet a lot of the characters in the story. We got to meet Mary and Joseph and the angels There will be more angels to come, don't you worry, and some sheep and shepherds. But one of the biggest themes of the first part of the story is people being worried. I don't know if you noticed, but Joseph, who does sleep in his overalls, in case you were curious, Joseph had his little worry emoji floating over his head because he was a little nervous about Mary being pregnant. And Mary gave the angel Gabriel all sorts of dirty looks before deciding to go with God's plan because she was worried about being pregnant. There are lots of parts of this story where people are worried about what's going to happen. Back when Mary and Joseph were starting this journey, being pregnant and not being married was a huge deal. And they were young. And so God walked with them and gave them angels along the way and gave them signs and brought them through this beautiful journey. And so I wanted to take a minute and talk about things that we do when we're worried, when we're anxious. Because right now, COVID's kind of a big deal. There are a lot of schools that aren't going to be in session until the middle of January. And so if you want to leave comments in the live stream about what you do when you're worried, Sarah, what do you do when you're worried?
When I'm worried, the only thing that I can do is remember that we can only take things one day at a time.
Mm.
And if that is too big for you, if one day is too big for you, you got to try to take things an hour at a time. And if you can get through that hour, you can get through that day. And then you can get through the next day. And if that hour seems too big, you can get through the next 10 seconds, right? 10 seconds at a time. It's just less, you just worry less that way when you don't think as big.
That's an interesting way to think about online learning, which is pretty much nobody's favorite thing. Important, but pretty much nobody's favorite thing. If you think about it one class at a time, instead of looking at your whole day, maybe you can chunk it up over the next couple weeks after we get past the holiday. Thinking through, or if you're a parent who is super stressed about tomorrow and how that might end up panning out with the kids and social distancing and family and Zoom calls, take it a little bit at a time. Now, if you need a little bit of extra help in this anxious season, we have some amazing colorable printables that are made by Illustrated Ministry, who made this wonderful play. And so you can email Sarah and I. I've got my fancy whiteboard here. If you want us to email you the link to get those printable coloring pages, we would be happy to share them with you. You can print them out at home. You don't have to worry about us mailing them to you or how long they will take to get to you. Oh, don't take a hymnal. There we go. I'm just picking on them. My husband's back there doing some of the AV, so I can pick on them. And so, yes, education@centralumcendicott.org is our email address. Email us, and we will send you some that's got some biblical stuff, some prayers that you can just color in, and you pray as you color. And it might help you feel a little less worried this holiday season and beyond. Just a little kind of pro tip of something that you can do to help when you're anxious, because prayer goes a long way. And sometimes when you're more of a doer and you want to be moving, coloring while you pray makes a big deal. So here's our email address. You can email us if you want to get those anxiety resources or if you want to connect with us for any of our other children's programming. And so the next part of our journey takes us to quite a character. I don't know if you remember what Sarah said in the video, but next we get to go meet the emperor.
Citizens of Rome, it is I, your Lord and Savior, Good Shepherd, Light, Way, and Prince of Peace, Caesar Augustus. First, I want to say you're welcome. For all the great things I've done for you, there has never been as emperor, as powerful, and as glorious as me. My empire is vast, you people are obedient. I'm saving you all of you. And you owe me so much, so much. Citizens, I want to count you. Yes, let's have a good head count. See how much you have to pay me all that I'm owed. So go to your hometowns and register with your families so that you can show a proper appreciation to all of my awesomeness. I decree it to be so. Farewell, my faithful children. May you know my magnificent ways. Farewell.
Okay, good news. I think I found us the place to stay.
Finally! This baby is not gonna wait much longer. Where are we staying? Please tell me it's the place we stayed last time. With the pancake machine and those little cinnamon rolls. Oh, Mama wants a cinnamon roll.
Not exactly. It was full.
It was full? What are we gonna do? Are we gonna stay outside with the shepherds? Or in the stable with animals?
What? No. Who would do that?
Joseph, this baby is coming.
I know. The guest rooms are full, but I found an innkeeper who will let us stay in a small space in his home.
Good.
Yeah, it's a nice space. It's a nice space. It's a little small. It's got some hay.
Hay?
Maybe a few animals?
A few animals. All right. Let's do this, but I expect a cinnamon roll when it's all over.
Talk about that later. The Bible doesn't really tell us anything about the birth anyway. It just says that Mary had the baby and wrapped him in strips of cloth and put him in a feeding trough or manger. That's it. But those are important details to remember for the next part of our story. It takes place in a field.
Okay, keep going.
Since there were shepherds living outside in the fields nearby, watching over their sheep, they were about to be frightened by some powerful messengers from God. But they would soon realize that they did not have to be afraid.
I don't know if you all have noticed, but I kind of love my job. We have been laughing this whole time, watching the videos along with you. And so thank you so much to the Central family for being the kind of congregation that lets us play in the sandbox like this and create these pieces of art. And thank you to the actors and the musicians and the AV team who is here all night through the 7 o'clock service. And just thank you so much. This has been such a riot. So the second part that we just watched, we saw Caesar Augustus and you saw Mary and Joseph. This fellow Mary, who's earlier on, also wants some cinnamon rolls, so I totally understand where she's coming from, especially having had two babies already. When you want a cinnamon roll and you're pregnant, Joseph should have been in the car on his way.
I want some now.
So one of the things that we wanted to take a minute and talk about is Mary and Joseph's plans changed pretty quick. They were probably planning to have the baby at their home. They were planning to be around where they were familiar, what they knew. And so that kind of reminds me of where we're at with Christmas this year, where all of a sudden there might not be a Caesar Augustus decreeing that everything has to be turned upside down this year, but there is a pandemic and there are things that are going to be different. And so I wanted you to take a minute to think about the traditions that you have that are going to be different this year and the traditions that you have that are going to be the same. For my family, every morning on Christmas, not every morning, on Christmas we wake up and make crescent rolls. That's just what we have every morning, Christmas morning after we open presents. My mom did it, and now I do it. That is not something that we have to change in the wake of COVID. But we will be doing a Zoom call with some family members that we would normally go see. And so there was some Amazon shipping of gifts that we don't normally do this year. And so that's going to be different, the annual holiday Zoom call. And I know I've talked to a lot of people who are doing that. And so what do your holiday traditions look like, and what's going to be different?
Well, so far my Christmas Eve is almost the same, except for I'm up here with you, and there's nobody here. There are no handbells. I did take a selfie of myself with the tree. Usually I take a picture with my family, but at least I have my selfie. Tomorrow, my day is going to look a little different because I'm not leaving my house. Every Christmas of my entire life, I've left my house as a child, as an adult, as a mother, and I've gone so many different places in one day, and it's fun, and I love to see my family, but it's very exhausting. And tomorrow is the first day that I am not leaving my house. Well, I'm going to stay home. My children are going to go to their father's house, and they're going to see their other family, and I'll be there.
Nice.
It'll be different. Yeah. But I'm looking forward to it. It's not all bad. I get to just be home, and I like that.
And just to remind everyone, there are two other worship services going on tonight. May or may not be in keeping with what your last year's routine is. So at 7 o'clock is the live stream plus live. You can watch it from home, or you can watch it here in the sanctuary with masks on, social distancing. There are going to be a few things that are different. We had mentioned the handbells. We definitely miss those. And having the kids up, we had a video from last year because we aren't able to bring them together to sing this year. We got a little teary-eyed when we were watching them sing, and so that was tough. But then there's also an 11:30 service, and that is a no-tech, candlelight, communion, really chill service where you get to gather around the Lord's table, mask, social distance, and gather around the Lord's table to bring in Christmas morning. And so those are your two options to worship with us again. This obviously fills a part of your heart, but there are some other more traditional pieces that I would imagine you want to connect with as well. And so I look forward to seeing you on the live stream chat for some of those, and hopefully they become part of your traditions. And so the next part of our journey involves a lot more fun characters, the shepherds and the magi. And so we're going to keep traveling onward.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God. Glory to God. Is this working? Is this thing? Am I on mute? Are you people listening? Are you listening? Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He's the Messiah. He's the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger. It's good news for all the people. A Savior is born, the Messiah. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those who God favors. That's all. Goodbye.
Yeah, we are going. We have to go.
Do we bring the sheep?
I think we have to.
Bye-bye. Yeah, we want to come. Take us with you. Bye-bye.
What were those signs again?
A baby. Wrapped in stripes of cloth. Why is it in a manger? Bah!
We won't forget. Let's go.
You too, sheep. Come on. It was exactly how the angel had described. The baby was wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Friends, we have seen something beautiful or amazing tonight. I don't know about you, but it feels like the world is changing.
Yeah, but why do you think we got to see it? Nobody cares about us shepherds. We're poor and we don't have very much power.
I have no idea. But the baby's mother Mary acted like this was exactly what was supposed to happen. Like this was meant for people like this. Maybe the Bailey will lift up the lowly.
And bring down the lofty. Wouldn't that be something?
It sure would. I believe there's no limit to what this baby can do.
My shepherds, what's that star there? Last night? I don't think I've ever seen that one before.
Twinkle, twinkle! Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Hello, and welcome to our observatory. We are the wise men.
Wise people.
The magi.
We're really more like scientists.
Astronomers. We study the stars.
We study the stars so well that when something changes, we notice immediately.
And we just noted, we just noticed a new star. We must follow our scientific instincts and find out why there's a new star in the sky.
We now begin our journey.
Are we there yet?
You literally just asked that.
Now?
Oh, yes, yes, it looks like we're here.
Ha!
Hi, here it is, Bethlehem. Let's look up the local king and see if we can get some more information.
Did somebody say king? That would be me. I'm the big cheese around here. Everybody's talking about it. They say I am a powerful king, the best king Bethlehem has ever seen.
We got it. Best king ever.
So, we're here because we are looking for the newly born king.
The child born king of the Jews?
We observed his star at its rising.
And we have come here to worship him and honor him.
Would you excuse me for a moment? I need to make a call. Hey, put me through on your smart people. Hi, this is your king, the very best king. I need to know, according to your research, where is the Messiah supposed to be born? Bethlehem. Are you sure? Oh, bye. Hi there, wise folks. So, yeah, this is great. I go on and honor him. And get back to me about this so I, too, can honor him.
Sure, okay.
We can do that.
Let's get out of here.
When we left Herod, he decided to sit around and be jealous and plan his revenge.
He felt very threatened that there was a new leader and that people were excited to meet him.
We found Jesus, and we brought gifts to this special child.
We brought gold,
frankincense,
and myrrh.
Usually these gifts, they're just for royalty.
Powerful people.
Grown men.
But we brought these gifts to a tiny, weak, and oppressed child.
Even though we didn't know exactly what was going on, we knew he was important.
This good news would turn everything upside down.
Oh, and by the way, we didn't return to that wicked King Herod.
Nope, no way. We were warned in the dream to take a different way home.
You might say we took the scenic route.
And now we return to our jobs, watching the stars.
People were really brave. They honored the king God had chosen, brought him presents, disobeyed the orders of King Herod, and made it home safely.
Yeah, they were brave and they were determined. And everyone in the story was, I think, from Mary and Joseph to the shepherds and the magi, they all recognized that the birth of Jesus was going to change the world. Hey, Dee, are you feeling safe and sleepy yet? Our story is about to come to an end.
Yes, I feel safe and sleepy, but this isn't really the end.
No, why not? It's bedtime. We need to get some sleep.
Daniel, this is just the beginning. Jesus is born, he grows up, he changes water to wine, he teaches, he heals, he flips tables,
He did. Yes, you're right. Jesus' birth is just the beginning, and we have a lot to talk about. But it's late. Tonight, let's focus on this special moment, this one night that brought us Jesus.
Okay, that makes sense. This is a good story. Yeah!
God's story is unfolding more good news every day. And in the end, all things will be made right. That doesn't mean we won't be afraid along the way, but we can trust that love and justice will have the final word. Speaking of the final word, let's have a final word from Mary, the mother of Jesus.
Last word. But I get the last word after Mary, just to be clear. So don't go after Mary talks. You will be hearing in a minute one of the most profound speeches or calls or songs or whatever it was.
My soul magnifies the Lord.
In its time, of which we just got a beautiful sneak preview of Victoria's voice. And so it's going to come up on the screen in a minute, and I put the words alongside of it. So if you want to lift up your voice alongside this young adult in our congregation, I think that that could be really meaningful in a couple of different ways. Where, you know, she's putting herself out there, she's by herself on the screen and reading the Magnificat and hearing her voice. The song behind it, if you can hear it, is It Is Well With My Soul. It's performed by Jerry Hotchkiss and Sean Stafford. So you can feel that. As well as just, it's our job to lift our voices up alongside the young voices in the congregation. And this is a way to do it without her being here in this place, but it's a way for us to do it in spirit, like we do with all of the youth and the children of this congregation, even in the midst of a pandemic. One of the things that we're going to be doing next week is we will be gathering via Zoom so that we can get to see each other and encourage each other in this adventure. Can you mention when that is?
That will be happening on Wednesday, December 30th at 3 p.m. So will we email the link?
Yep. And so if you aren't already on our church email list, call the church office and we'll get you on that. But it'll be Wednesday the 30th. I also gave you my email a little bit earlier. You can email us for that. But it is time to raise up our voices around one of the young adults of our church who is proclaiming the Magnificat while the song It Is Well With My Soul goes in the background. This is a pretty profound moment that we chose to end this service with. And then we will close with a moment of prayer. Shall we begin?
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For you, God, have looked with favor on the lowliness of your servant. Surely now on all generations will call me blessed. For you, the Mighty One, has done great things for me, and holy is your name. Your mercy is those who feared God from generation to generation. You, O God, have shown me strength with your arms. You have shattered the proud in thoughts of their hearts. You, God, have brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. You have helped your servant Israel in remembrance of your mercy, according to the promises you made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to their descendants forever. The end.
So it was fitting, friends, to end with the voice of one of our young adults. It is our job to raise up those voices, whether it is through our AV ministry or through our faith formation or through our programs, through our volunteer opportunities, or through just reaching out. It's important now, as important as ever. May we all come together around the story of a young man and a young woman who are just trying to figure things out, in the story of the birth of Jesus. May you go forth with the spirit of peace and hope, and Christmas unlike any other, and joy in your hearts. Amen.